At times I see my life in chains. Oh, lonely road. Someone tell me, why am I this way? Tears cascading down my eyes. What have I done? What is really going on? What could be wrong? True love cause me pain.
Look, where have you been all day that Princess had to wait for you?
I went to return a book and Princess is aware of that.
She might be aware, but I am not. Look, I must know you in and out of this house. Am I understood? I believe I'm talking to somebody here.
Mom, why is it that everything I do in this house seems to be wrong with you? Whatever I do is just so wrong, but whatever Princess does, she's right. Mom, what have I done to deserve all of this?
What is going on in here?
Good afternoon, Mom.
Good afternoon.
I'm very sorry if I offended you yesterday. I didn't mean to say the things I said.
Never mind.
Mom, I'm going to the library. I won't be long.
Take care of yourself and don't be logging coming.
Sweetheart, I'm back! Come on. That's not the way to welcome your man.
Well, I hope you don't expect me to jump up and down in ecstasy just because you deemed it fit to come back now, are you?
Not really, but a kiss would do.
Welcome back. Are you satisfied?
Nah. Come on.
Wow, I missed you today.
I missed you too.
Well, if you missed me, how come you stayed out so long? I mean, this is my first time in Ghana, and I don't know anywhere. Stop that!
I'm so sorry, okay? I just met this old friend of mine and childhood friends some time back, and I needed to find a location, okay? I'm sorry.
Okay.
I'll make it up to you. I mean...
Promise.
I'll start now. Like this evening. I'll take you out. You've not seen the city at night.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Now?
Yes.
Yes! I love that. I love it.
Cool.
I'll go get changed.
Okay.
Let me help you change.
Ah, thank you, darling. But no thanks. My hands work just fine. I'll be back.
Okay, then.
It's so wonderful here, darling. Thank you for bringing me.
You're welcome.
And thank you for giving me a second chance. You know, after Maxwell, I never thought you would want to have anything to do with me.
What happened between you and Maxwell? It's past. It's gone. So please don't remind me of it.
I know. It's just that I can't believe how foolish I was to believe Maxwell's lies. Darling, I know I hurt you so much. So I never thought you would ever forgive me. I thought I would lose you to someone else. But when you said you forgave me, it really felt like a miracle.
So do me that favor and let's forget about it, okay? I forgive you because I love you. And I want you to use the same love to forget about it, okay?
Alex, promise me you'll never use what happened against me. Promise me you'll never leave me for someone else.
Put a ring on your finger, my dear. And that's why I want it till eternity.
Unless perhaps after 75 years you want me to sign a release for you, I would.
Honey, I love you. I really do.
I love you too. Thank you.
Please eat for me.
In town for a while, and I've all the time being in my guest house.
Oh, yes. I see.
Gladys, you're looking so lovely.
Thank you, thank you.
I'd rather say so gorgeous. Oh, and Gladys, I admire you so much.
Thank you.
And I'd rather say you're very industrious.
Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
I've been looking for the opportunity to invite you for a candlelit dinner, at least to cool off your busy schedule. I hope you wouldn't mind. Just this weekend.
I think I'll check on my schedule and get back to you. Anyway, thanks for the invitation.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thanks so much. Most welcome.
Thank you.
Please, try as much as possible to fulfill this invitation.
I will. I will.
Admire you so much.
Thanks a lot. Anyway, I'll take a look.
That's good. Have a nice day.
Thanks. Thanks. Bye.
Bye.
In the school, I mean this institution.
Yes, I am.
Yeah, I'm looking for one lady. Her name is Ruth. She's a little busty. Average height. She's in the botany department.
Mm. Yeah. I'm sorry, I'm not too sure I know her.
Okay. All right. Okay, I'm sorry to intrude, but my name is Alex.
Anita.
Anita. Anita Battels.
Yes.
You are Anita Battels?
No.
What a small world!
I'm sorry, but how do you know me?
You grew up in the same neighborhood. I mean, like, how many years ago? Alex Benson, come on.
Alex! Oh my god, Alex, little Alex!
Go away, what is little Alex?
Oh my god, you look so big now! Alex, what did you do to yourself? I mean, well, Alex, where have you been?
I was not around. I came back like 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
Yeah. But Ruth is here. You've not met her.
Are you serious? You mean like Ruth is here? How long has she been here and I don't know?
Like 2 years?
I'll try to look for her. Oh my god.
Where is Princess?
My sister.
Of course.
She's at home. I'm sure she was so happy that I met you today. I will tell her.
I hope you still live in your same neighborhood, right?
Of course, my father's house. I can't move until I get married.
Okay, it means your number. Just give me your number.
Okay, 0244-677-699.
Okay, so I'll call you, don't tell her. I will just bump you. I'll find you.
Yeah, sure, do that.
You're looking sweet.
Hey, Alex. Look at how big you are. Alex, call me, yo.
How can I make it go away? I want to know. Loneliness I feel inside. Need someone to hold. At times I see my life in chains. Oh, Lord. Someone tell me, why am I this way? Tears cascading down my eyes. What have I done? What is really going on?
What's wrong, sis?
Nothing.
What do you mean nothing? I know something is eating you up. Come on, tell me, what's it? What is it?
It's Mom.
Mom, what about Mom?
Princess, nothing I do in this house seems to be okay with Mom. I mean, I try my hardest to cook, to clean, to do everything that I think would please her, but she's never pleased.
Anita, you know Mom scolds me sometimes.
But the way she scolds you is different. It's so obvious how she treats me in this house. You know, sometimes I even wonder if Dad is not my real father.
Anita! How could you say something like that? What do you mean Dad is not your dad?
So why would she treat me like this, Princess? Why would she do that? You know? I just want to know, so maybe I could go out there and then look for my real father.
I said stop saying that, okay? I'll try and talk to her for you, okay?
You will?
I will, okay? Now cheer up. And? Champ, let's grab our swimsuits and have a swim.
Okay.
What are you going to wear, the pink suit or the green?
You know, actually, I think I'll wear the purple one.
So that's how I lost my joy and became a widow at a tender age. Right now, I've put all my trust in God and to see my children go through life.
I see. In fact, Gladys, I think we have almost the same experience. And that makes us one of a kind, you know? You see, I watched my wife's life for 5 years destroyed by cancer. In fact, since then, I have raised my son single-handedly. The pain that she went through and her eventual death put me off marriage totally, totally. But I know with the love that I had for her, it's all gone to my son. But I would have wished to be with someone though, but anyway, thanks so much for honoring my invitation. Let's cheers to that.
Cheers.
I have one confession to make. That's, excuse me to say this, you remind me so much of my late wife. She was as gorgeous as you are, very hardworking, she had charisma. Everything about you reminds me of her. I don't know, I shouldn't be saying these things.
I just thought to check out the shops and boutiques and see what they have to offer and try and see if I can hunt down something I can entice you with. Wanna come?
Nah, I don't think I find it that pleasurable. You go alone, you'll be fine. And besides, I'll be seeing the girls later too.
The girls?
Yeah.
What girls?
I told you about this friend I met. Childhood friend.
Childhood friend?
Yeah.
Well, I thought it was a guy.
Come on. I mean, lucky. I wish Anita was here to help me call her guy. Come on, baby. Anita is nowhere near a guy.
Anita?
Yeah, Anita Battles. I mean, we're living next door to each other. Anita, her sister, myself.
Oh.
I mean, could you imagine? I fancied myself being in love with her at that age.
I never thought. Just give my love to them, okay? I'm around now.
Happy hunting.
Princess! Yeah? How are you doing, dear? You're looking sweet.
10 years.
Yeah.
No, he was really, really little.
And you were grown up.
You remember when he used to bath outside?
Imagine.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Where did you find him?
Surprise. It's a little world, you know.
Yeah, you're grown up, sweet.
Alex, you remember my mom, right?
Yeah.
Hello, mom.
What do you want? What would you like to have?
What do you guys have?
Anything you want.
Okay, we ain't kids no more, right? So, anything on rocks.
Okay, I'll do that. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Oh my god. So, Alex, you look so nice. What have you been doing to yourself?
Well, almost a bit of everything. I go into music, I go into everything.
Are you
serious? Yeah.
Oh my god, because you look so good.
Yeah, thank you. You're looking sweet, too.
Oh, thank you.
Princess.
Yes, mommy.
I know you don't have the audacity to bring a man in my house if it's not a plot of Anita.
Mommy, it's high time you realize that we're not little girls anymore. We're grown-ups. And for your information, Anita did not initiate him in here.
Well, I acknowledge your maturity. But that won't be at the detriment of my comfort in this house. I don't want to talk for her to think I don't love her.
Mommy, when are you going to realize that Anita's your daughter and she's my sister? You're making life unbearable for her, please.
Beyonce.
Oh, really?
You mean I actually look like Beyonce?
Mm-hmm.
You're so crazy. Well, don't tell me. I know. You're going on a date. A date?
Mm-hmm.
Princess, you're so crazy. What actually makes you think I'm going on a date?
You're blushing. Look at you. I can see it in your eyes.
Okay, well, listen. I'm very sorry to disappoint you. But I'm actually going to look for a job.
Job?
Of course a job.
Anita, has it gotten to this situation?
Princess, look, mom has been making my life a living hell in this place. I just want to go out there and then get myself busy.
If only she wasn't my mother.
You know what, Princess, you take care of yourself, okay? I'll be right back, alright?
But why didn't you tell me about this?
Princess, I just wanted it to be a surprise for both you and mom. Okay.
So does she know about this?
She doesn't know. And I hope you don't tell her. I just want to surprise her, okay?
Alright, come on. You take care of yourself, alright? Suit yourself.
Do I really look like Beyonce?
Oh, get out. Good luck, okay?
Thank you. I'm going to need it.
Dad, you don't look all right. Something must be wrong. Moreover, I heard you on the phone complaining about the business. It's not good, is it?
Fred, you're right. My business. Business that I've toiled for so many years is dwindling. Dwindling so fast, I don't understand. Expenditure, always more expenditure. And I've been paying taxes. One day I'll wake up to find my business blown away, blown with the wind. I don't understand.
Dad, you need to slow down. You know you don't have a very strong heart. These things, don't let them bother you so much. But I share your sentiments, I understand. But you just need to take it light. Okay, I've got an idea. You know, I haven't been around here for a while, and not a lot of people know me, so let me just see what I can do. Let me talk to a few people, pull some few strings, and see what I can come up with.
And how do you intend to do that?
Hi, Mom. Oh, bye, good morning.
Good morning.
I'm fine, thank you.
What?
Have you forgotten?
Forgotten what?
Today's my birthday.
Oh, happy birthday.
Thank you.
Where's Princess?
She left early. I don't know where she really gone to.
Okay. I'm relaxing a bit.
Someone to hold. At times I see my life in chains. Oh, lonely road. Someone tell me, why am I this way? Tears cascading down my eyes. What have I done? What is really going on? What could be wrong? A broken soul, how could true love cause me pain?
Woo!
my dear. You missed out.
The birthday was so rich.
So wonderful. You need to see the surprise on Anita's face when Alex ushered her in and removed the blindfold from her eyes.
Really? I didn't even know the party was supposed to be a surprise. I thought the girls planned it by themselves.
No! Alex did! With the help of Prince, you know Princess now. Anita's younger sister. Yeah. Even the birthday dress was a surprise too.
Anita knew nothing about it.
At all. I see. So who paid for all the expenses?
Alex, of course. You know, Alex and the girls have really come a very long way. Anita especially.
Oh. Now I see.
That reminds me of Becky. What happened? We all expected to see you there. Why didn't you show up?
Need you to love me. Need you to care. Take all my sorrows away. Your worries are over. I'll always be there to love you till the end of my days. I never meant to cause you pain. I love you so.
Hello, sweetheart.
Alex, what the hell is going on between you and Anita?
Anita and myself are very good friends. Why do you ask?
Oh, just very good friends, right? But that's not what this picture was saying.
You organized and paid for another woman's birthday party, even bought her a sexy dress to go with it, and you stand there and tell me you're just friends. What do you take me for, Alex? A fool?
Where did you get these?
Yeah, well, you hid them, of course. I knew it, Alex. I knew there was something more to you and that girl than meets the eye. But you continue to deny it, you two-timing bastard!
For Christ's sake, what is wrong with you? Why do you keep on fabricating stories when there's none? Making yourself unhappy along? I have told you time and time again, Anita and I are just friends. How else do you want me to convince you?
Alex,
the evidence is staring us right into the face and it proves that otherwise. What, so are my eyes deceiving me now?
Listen, I promised you the day I put a ring on your finger that there's not going to be any other woman apart from you. I meant it. Why can't you just trust me? Then you would just realize...
Realize what, Alex? That you're a lying, cheating, two-timing bastard who cannot stand by his words?
I know where you're coming from. It's Maxwell, right? Let me make this point clear. Not everybody is a cheat who sleeps with one man and get engaged to the other. The fact that you did it to me doesn't mean I'll pay you back in your own coin, no.
You bastard!
Good afternoon, Mom.
Good afternoon. Anita, you never told me you're looking for a job at Barnett's.
Mom, I wanted to surprise you. And I wanted you to appreciate me.
Appreciate you? Who told you I never appreciate you?
Maybe you're just telling me now.
Maybe. Anyway, you finally made it. You got a job.
I did? Mom, you mean like I made it? Oh, I'm so excited! Oh, Mommy, I'm going to prison! Oh, Mom!
So, yes, Ms. Battle, can I see you in my office? Yes, now. Thanks.
Hello, sir.
Yes, Ms. Battle, how are you doing?
Okay.
Ms. Battle, meet Fred. He's just been employed as your new driver.
Okay.
Fred, that's Ms. Battle. He's the public relations officer of this company.
Morning, madam.
You can just call me Anita.
Good morning, Anita.
Good morning. Is that all, sir?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
All right. Thank you, sir. I'm not too sure, but I'm trying to figure it out.
You're a driver. I thought you were supposed to know car problems and everything that happens with our cars.
I'll figure it out.
Well, can you please hurry, because I might be late for this board meeting, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
You're a bit late today.
Okay?
Of you. Don't wait up for me, okay?
Princess.
Mommy.
Hi.
I know you are a grown woman. And you already have a man in your life. Don't lie to me, Princess.
Mommy.
Look, I'm your mother. Anyway, there's someone I would like to introduce to you.
Who?
My business partner's son. Look, he's the kind of family I would like you to associate yourself with.
Mommy, don't tell me you're arranging a husband for me.
But what if I do? I would like to place you in a place of honor and dignity.
Mommy, save the news for later, okay? As I said, I'll be late tonight. Love you.
Love you too.
Please don't wait up.
Okay, we'll talk more when you come back.
All right, later.
From whom?
It's actually from you, Mom.
This is wonderful. But Anita, how can you lavish your money on such an expensive gift for me?
You deserve more than this, Mom.
you. Thank you. You're welcome. Mom, is Princess upstairs?
She might be somewhere in the room upstairs, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
I'll be upstairs then, okay?
Okay.
Its ownership. Then we file a claim against the insurance company for loss of goods on the high seas.
That's brilliant.
Then, what do we tell MD?
Simple.
Yeah?
The goods are missing in action. Then we commit him to pursue the insurance company.
But you know, the last assignment nearly backfired. Had it not been the intelligence of my bank manager.
Come on. This time round, I told the bank manager that it is going to be 50-50.
Oh. Shabu, shabu.
Sure.
Then we have a deal.
Of course.
See you, brother.
Details of which I don't want to go into. In fact, the unprecedented latest developments leading to very huge losses in profit.
In fact,
you're all aware, and I don't want to go into detail. Get me Fred right in the door. Yes. Boardroom, thank you. Now, I have taken a decision. From today onwards, I want to announce to you that the day-to-day management of this company is being transferred to my son, Fred. Every responsibility, from finance to administration, all is in his hands. And remember, you are all responsible to Fred, my son, as managers. And also remember, he is my personal representative in this company, pending the formation of a new board. That's your new CEO. Thank you very much.
I just want to say something short.
Some of you might be really surprised at the outcome of this. My father was at the verge of selling out, but I more or less got him convinced to keep this corporation running. To make the long story short, I just want to say we need a lot of team spirit in here. And with that high profile team spirit, we should forget the past and just move forward. That's it.
I thank you guys.
My sister Princess. Princess, this is Fred, the driver I told you that became my boss. Ooh. The son of Vanix.
Hi, Princess.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you too.
You're beautiful.
I believe it runs in the family.
Okay, we have to go now.
All right.
Pass by some sign.
I will. Bye. Nice to meet you.
Bye.
I like that.
We've got the place. Now tell me, what on earth can I offer you?
Actually, I'm just from a meeting and it was more like a cocktail than a meeting. And I had a little too much to drink, so your reception for now should do. I'm cool.
I insist. What can I offer you?
Okay. Is there a drink called Anita?
I get it. All right. Toss come right up.
Can you make it four?
All right, I'll do that. Your drink's already here. Quick service, though.
Hi, you look gorgeous.
Thank you, so do you.
Thanks.
Well, anyways, I really have to go to the office. I have a couple of things to do, so I can't really stay, all right? Aww. But I'm very sure that my sister will give you a kingly reception, all right?
All right.
I have to go now, okay? So you take care.
All right, take care.
I won't be long, though.
Okay.
All right.
Don't be long.
Come on, have a seat.
Yeah.
So how's the business?
Business is all right. I mean, we try to make things work. It's a really tough world out there. If I start getting to the deep,
making all the money.
Yeah, right. You tell me about making money. I mean, you know. What are you interested in?
Well, right now I'm trying to figure out what I want to do. I'm trying to put up something, but then I don't really have. I don't know what exactly what I want to do, but then thinking of something. Yeah.
Hello.
Oh, mommy.
It's Fred.
Yes, it is.
Hello, you're welcome.
Thank you very much.
And how are you?
I'm doing well.
Your father?
He's excellent.
Oh, that's great. Anyway, extend my warmest greetings to him.
I'll do that.
Have fun, eh?
Thank you.
You look better today. May I come in?
Yeah, sure. Come
yeah? Cool. So, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Yeah?
Well, thanks for your concern.
You're welcome.
What I want to do is ask you for a favor. It's not really huge, but I wish you say yes.
Come on, say it. If it's something beyond my capacity, I'll simply say no.
Okay. I want to take you out. Somewhere really cool, smooth, quiet, cozy, good food. Come with your sister if you want. I mean, I'm okay with it if you're fine with that.
Really? That would be wonderful. I'll call her so she'll know, okay? That was so cool.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'll see you.
Sure.
Day after day, time passes away, and I just can't get you off my mind. Nobody knows I hide it inside. I keep on searching, but I can't find the courage to show, to letting you know, I've never felt so much love before. And once again, I'm thinking about taking.
Wow.
Did you enjoy your day out?
Thank you.
Yeah? Okay. Cool.
But thank you very much for the ride though.
Nah, you know, it pleases me to drive you every time. We can go again. You know.
Well, I'll let you know anytime.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I'll see you again.
All right. I'm gonna miss you.
Me too.
Call me.
I will.
Good afternoon. And how may I help you?
Well, I am being asked to deliver this to your daughter.
From whom?
From my boss, Fred Ajima.
Oh, Fred. Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Do have a nice day, madam.
Oh, you have a pleasant day too.
Thank you.
Your day too.
Oh, I've had such a hectic day. So I'll be upstairs in my room.
Okay.
Princess.
Yes, mommy?
That is for you.
Oh, wow. Thanks. Thank you.
Fred actually sent it this afternoon.
Who?
Fred.
Fred sent this for me? This afternoon?
Mm-hmm.
Mommy! Wow! Look at this!
This is beautiful!
Oh my God. Mommy!
This is beautiful, Princess!
Look at the earrings!
Oh, they're so lovely!
How do I look?
Oh, you're the princess that you are!
Oh my God! Beautiful! Oh! How do I look, mommy? Oh my God, it is so beautiful! Oh my God! I can't believe this! This is beautiful! I have to give this to Anita. Where is Anita? I'll be right back, mommy! Annie! Annie girl! Guess what
gonna give you a clue. Okay, starts with an F.
F, uh-huh.
Well, duh, I can't figure out, it's just an F.
Okay.
Ends with a D.
A D.
D. Oh, what is this, an IQ test? Princess, just tell me. E in the middle.
An A, Princess, just tell me.
Oh my God, I mean, can't you guess?
Me? Guess. Okay.
And has an R in the middle. Who could it be?
An R.
Uh-huh.
Fred.
Uh-huh. He got me then. It is so obvious. He is in love with me. And I am so happy. I can't believe it. I am so happy. Look, I couldn't forget you. I got this for you. Isn't it lovely?
Fred got that
for me. Uh-huh. And it's so it's obvious. He's in love with me. Isn't it lovely? I'm so happy. I'm going to call him first. I'll see you later, okay? I have to call him, okay? I'm going to call him. Don't worry about me. I'm right back.
Type of woman that society needs to look up to.
Thanks for your commendation, sir. Thank you very much.
You're most welcome.
Sir, I will also like to state that your support has kept alive small industries like ours from collapsing.
Oh. I'm flattered though. Thanks so much.
You're welcome. Sir, it has always been my desire to give my children a sound belonging. In fact, when I found myself in your business and my daughter in your office, I felt something bigger growing between the two families. Sir, it's actually about my daughter and your son, Fred.
Oh, Gladys. I see. So, you also noticed it? I see. In fact, I've been watching the two of them for the past weeks. And I don't know if it's love. But if it is love that has found its way into the heart of two young people, what can we do? Who are we to stop them?
That is why I've come for you to join them in hands. Before they bring shame into this noble family.
Oh, I see. Gladys, you know I'll do everything and anything for you.
Thank you.
Yes. And there is wisdom in what you just said. But first, I'll have to talk to my son, Fred. And then afterwards, I'll get back to you.
Make yourself comfortable. Good afternoon, madam.
Yes, I'm from Barnett Industries. Oh, I see. How may I help you?
Madam, there's a problem.
What problem?
Ma'am, I'm very sorry, but please, it's Anita, your biological daughter.
Of course. And why?
And what about Princess? Madam, 2 weeks ago, I heard my boss talking about his son getting married to Anita's sister, Princess. And I saw Anita romancing, kissing the sister's fiancé in the office. Actually, I went there to pick a file and I saw it. But I also heard her pleading that the guy should love her. She almost raped my director's son.
Okay. It's okay. It's okay. Thank you very much, my dear lady.
Okay. Then I'll take my leave.
Thank you very much. Emefa, what happened 20 years ago is about to repeat itself. I won't sit for Anita to destroy my daughter's happiness. Never. It won't happen again.
Not in this house.
Not. It won't. My goodness.
I want to know. Loneliness I feel inside. Need someone to hold. At times I see. To care, take all my sorrows away. Your worries are over, I'll always be there. Need you to love me, need you to care.